His Royal Highness, Christopher Rupert, Windermere, Vladimir, Carl Alexander, Francois Reginald, Lancelot Herman,
Herman,
Gregory James, is giving a ball.
The prince is giving a ball, the prince is giving a ball.
Our daughter is looking trivia.
Naturally.
And Joy?
I want you to live up to your name. I want you to be vivacious and alert, as well as beautiful.
Vivacious, alert, beautiful. Vivacious, alert,
beautiful. That does not mean, however, that I want you to neglect your beauty. Our family has always been noted for its fascinating women. Now let's all go upstairs and get our beauty sleep. I'm exhausted from all that shopping. Tomorrow I'm going to have to go into town and get a massage. That's the only thing that does me any good these days, a good massage.
I'm all tired out too, Ma, going from store to store the way we did.
You're tired?
Yes, I'm tired.
I suppose you think you're the only one that's tired.
Well, who bought the most?
That has nothing to do with that.
That has everything to do with it.
Go to bed, both of you.
Well, leave you alone. You're all fine. It's not the most.
That's right. Raise your voices. And you, don't just sit there looking at me. Clean this mess up.
Yes, ma'am. I wonder why they're so tired. Looking at all those beautiful things and buying so many of them, I was too excited to be tired. Oh, I love this room. When they've all gone out, there's nobody here but me.
Cinderella?
Yes, ma'am.
Quit stomping around on that like an elephant. We can't sleep. We're racking.
Yes, ma'am. I was just going to sit down anyway. I love sitting down. Right here.
Macy!
Go out of
James, I am his father.
A fine father you are.
What do you mean, a fine father you are?
I mean, you never worry about him.
Why should I worry about him?
Because he isn't happy.
How do you know?
He doesn't seem to have interest in anything or anyone.
Oh, he's happy, all right.
If he's so happy, why doesn't he get married?
If he is happy, why should he get married?
Look at your pants!
How could I have gained so much weight in 5 years?
Because that's all you've done for 5 years. Gained weight. You haven't worn your court costume because we haven't given a ball in 5 years. You've done nothing to give your people any fun. Not a festival, not a fair, not a pageant. You've done nothing to make your people love you.
Ah, but they do anyway. Don't they?
The royal tailor will have to make you another suit.
That'll cost money!
Oh, don't start to worry about what you're going to pay the tailor. Wait until you see what this ball's going to cost.
Daisy, this is no time to splurge. The exchequer is very low and I can't afford
it. I have the chef and steward waiting outside to report their plans for the dinner.
The dinner?
Certainly. You can't give a ball without a dinner. Come in, gentlemen.
Don't have them in here.
Your Majesty, a list of the bare necessities.
A list of the bare necessities.
For what?
For 1,700 guests.
That seems a lot. Don't have any king crab.
Very well, Your Majesty.
I hate to see that written on the menu. King crab seems like a common of my disposition.
1,000 baby lobsters for the salmon.
Wow.
And 500 pheasant for the pie.
Aye,
aye. 1,000 pounds of caviar.
1,000?
Gosh.
It's more than the surgeon can supply.
I told you, steward, to get us 40 acres of lettuce and 600 suckling pigs for roasting.
Uh-huh. What about the marshmallows?
Who wants marshmallows?
I do.
Why?
For toasting.
Now, please, Your Majesties, I have a list of wine. The best of all the vintages, every nation's mine.
I want the wine of my country.
Hush, hush, hush.
Sherry and port and muscatel, Kimlin, Rudolph. Dry champagne and sweet from Marcel, Burgundy and Chablis. Aquavit and Lee from Milch, Hock and chocolate, malty milk, brandy, drabouille and vodka, white and crystal clear.
I want the wine of my country, I want the wine of my country, I want the wine of my country, the wine of my country is beer. Darn ball. You know that ball you're throwing with my money?
Oh, Ned.
Well, to tell you the truth, sir, it's not a night I'm looking forward to. Dancing with all those candidates. Every simpering girl in the kingdom, each one determined to show that she would be the perfect princess for me.
I know you feel. More fun to chase one girl than just to be stampeded by a whole herd of them.
One thing is for sure, whomever I marry, it won't be anyone I meet at the ball.
I know you feel, but there's one thing we mustn't forget. Your mother's got her heart set on giving this event.
Yes, I know.
Now, Christopher, if you talk to your mother about this, tell her that you love the idea of giving the ball. Tell her that you... No! Hello, my dear. We were just... Christopher and I were just...
I was just saying, Mother, how much I'm looking forward to the ball. It sounds wonderful.
Does it?
Yes! I was wondering if I could help you at all. I mean, in any of the preparations?
Well, yes, dear. Maybe you can.
Can I see them bring my horse around for the stables now?
Have you got the sniffles?
No.
Getting a cold? Better take something for it. Don't have a red nose at the ball.
Oh, I'll be okay by then.
Daisy.
What?
That boy is unhappy.
How do you know?
I asked him. He said he's feeling fine.
Did he? You know something?
What?
I love you.
Naturally you do. I am the king.
Got it, you have
haven't got it. And Cinderella hasn't got it.
Cinderella, my fan.
Cinderella, my reticule.
Cinderella, my handkerchief.
Here, dear. Well, you all look so beautiful.
Yes, don't we?
Cinderella, the flowers. Come along, girls.
Nothing happens without wishing. Everything has to start with a wish. Juno was fishing tonight, just before you came.
I'm almost afraid to hear.
Do you see that pumpkin out in the yard?
I nearly stumbled over it in the dark.
Well, the moon is shining on it now. I was wishing that this pumpkin would turn into a great big royal golden carriage that would take me to the ball tonight.
Then what were you going to do for horses?
Four white mice. White mice would turn into horses. Beautiful white prancing steeds.
And were you going to drive them yourself?
Oh, no. There would be a coachman and a footman and a monkey in the back seat.
And where were they coming from?
They could be the three baby rats I saw down in the cellar yesterday.
Oh, I know what you're going to say.
Fal-de-ral and fiddle-dee-dee.
Yes, fal-de-ral and fiddle-dee-dee.
It's impossible, I suppose.
Impossible.
Just the same, it was what I was wishing, and I'm still wishing it.
Nonsense.
I'm wishing it very hard.
You are?
Yes, I am. If only I had some kind of magical help. If only I had a guardian angel, or if my godmother were a fairy godmother.
Fairy godmother? Cinderella, that's ridiculous.
I am wishing. In the name of every young girl who has wished to go to a dance and was told she couldn't, I am wishing that I may go to that dance tonight. I wish that by some kind of magic or abracadabra or fal-de-ral or fiddle-dee-dee, all the kind hearts would put their heads together.
All the kind hearts would put their heads together?
Oh, you know what I mean. That all the kind hearts and good souls will wish with me, and that you, godmother, will help me with every ounce of strength and cleverness you possess.
Cinderella.
Yes?
It's impossible.
Impossible. I suppose so.
Impossible for a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carriage. Impossible for a plain country bumpkin and a prince to join in marriage. And four white mice will never be four white horses. Such fal-de-ral and fiddle-dee-dee and horses. Impossible. But your world is full of sameies and fools who don't believe in sense. Believe what sensible people say. And because these dappled dewy eyed dolls keep building up impossible hopes and impossible things are happening every day. Impossible, 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 impossible.
True, godmother?
Well, yes, in a way.
Then I continue to build up my impossible wish, and I officially wish.
Officially wish?
I officially wish and wish and wish all those things I said about the pumpkin and the mice and the rats.
Cinderella, it's impossible.
Just the same, I'm wishing it.
Believe it.
one of these things, I couldn't stand another. Besides, all I can do is grant you your wish. How it turns out from here is up to you.
But I'm scared to go in here all by myself.
You needn't be, except for one thing. See that you're in the coach and off for home before the clock strikes 12.
But Godmother, why is it so important that I leave before 12?
Just obey and don't ask any questions.
But Godmother...
Godmother?
Where are you?
Where did she go? She just vanished out of sight. Have you ever seen anything like that before?
Many times.
Well, it's the first time I've ever seen anything like it.
You'll see worse if you're not out of here by midnight.
I'm ready.
Or something about how, like, the quality of mercy. Well, they're very much the same as yours.
Destroy the garden?
I saw you. is too crowded.
It's nice around here.
Yes, it is. With the moon beaming down on us. What's the matter?
I must go.
Why?
Because I promised my godmother.
Your godmother will understand if you were a little late.
Oh, no, she won't. You don't understand. I have a strange kind of godmother.
Your godmother will understand. You haven't yet told me your name.
Oh, it's a silly name. You wouldn't like it.
Of course I would. Whatever your name is, it is the most beautiful name in the world. Whatever you are called, I love you. I will always love you. I have just told you that I love you, and yet you don't say anything.
I'm afraid to. I'm afraid I might wake up.
Are you sure you're asleep?
Oh, yes.
Are you dreaming that I'm about to kiss you? It is strange how things happen. A girl I never saw before comes down the flight of stairs, and suddenly my whole life has changed. And suddenly I am deeply in love. And yet I don't know why I'm in love. Do you?
Do I what?
Do you know why I'm in love? What did you think I meant?
I thought you meant, do I know why I am in love?
Do you? I mean, are you?
Yes.
And do you know why?
No, I don't care why.
I always want to know why I do anything, why I feel anything. And so I ask myself why you, a stranger, are suddenly the only kind of girl I could love, and you are the only one of your kind. Why is the sound of your voice the sweetest sound in the world? Why is the color of your hair the only color a girl's hair should be? Why would I rather hold you in my arms than do anything else in the world? Why?
Because, Your Highness.
Topher.
That is the way you feel.
But why do I feel that way? What makes you so miraculous?
Your imagination.
Then what makes my imagination so miraculous?
I love you because you're beautiful. Or are you beautiful? Because I love you. Am I making believe I see in you a girl too lovely to be really true? Do I want to because you're wonderful?
Tell me your name.
Clock!
in the loneliness of sunrise. When the deep purple heaven turns blue, and start to pray as I pray each day, that I'll hear some word from you. I lie in the loneliness of evening, looking out on a silver-flaked sea, and ask the moon, oh, how soon will my love come home to me? I have found
on the sky above the park, and below them is a row of lighted windows.
like a statue on a stair. You're afraid to hear the way your heart is beating, and you know you mustn't make the first advance. You are seriously thinking of retreating. Then you seem to hear him asking you to dance.
The stars in it.
are you going to do?
Sir, may I have your royal guards descend to the kingdom in search of her?
Of course you may.
And your secret service, may I call them in as well to help me?
Of course. They never do anything, but you can try.
I will try everything. I will search every inch of the kingdom for the owner of this slipper.
Well, that's what I would do. Well, it is.
See that the slipper is tried on every young maiden, every last one, no matter how likely she looks. You are to keep trying until you find the one that fits. Do you understand?
Yes, Your Highness.
Find that girl!
I will just go speak with the chief of my secret service.
Topher, suppose you don't find her.
I must find her.
Before last night, you knew nothing about her. You only knew that she looked nicely and that she danced prettily.
I know that she's the loveliest thing on earth, and I will never be happy without her.
Why do you think that?
I don't know why, and I don't expect you to understand, Mother.
But I do understand, Topher. I know it doesn't take long for you to feel the way you do about this girl. But there is one fact that I want you to face. You may never see this girl again. I don't want you to waste your life on a dream. I want you to be in love with a real girl.
She is real.
She was real last night. If she doesn't come back, she will never be real again, will she? Don't be angry with me. Think over what I am saying. Ask yourself if this is not just an illusion, an infatuation with something that doesn't exist at all.
I know you're out there. I don't know where. You said last night that you thought we were dreaming. Maybe you were right. Maybe my mother was right. How can I know? How can one ever know?
I love you because you're beautiful.
Aren't she beautiful? Because you want her.
Am I making believe I see you? A girl too lovely to be really true.
Thank you.
Well, they almost fit. Does that count?
I'm afraid not.
Oh, Mother, honestly, it's my shoe. I throw this shoe anywhere. You see? It fits perfectly. Oh.
Are you all right?
Let me try! What are you doing? You drop it! Shrink it! Try it!
Give me the shoe! Enough! Is there anybody else in the house?
No, there's nobody else here.
What about Cinderella?
Who is Cinderella?
Why, she's no one. She's just a sort of maid in general help around here. It'd be of no use trying the slipper on her.
I have instructions to try the shoe on everyone.
Try upstairs.
What right have you to come poking your nose into our business?
I thought it was the prince's business. He is the one looking after the missing girl, isn't he?
But Cinderella?
Well, she is a girl.
There's nobody up there.
Nobody there?
I told you so.
Isn't that just like Cinderella? She hasn't even finished the laundry!
Or the floor!
And someone should really sweep out the fireplace.
And she hasn't washed our gown.
And the dishes.
Night. Cinderella not there? Well, where could she be? I know.
Tried the slipper and every young maiden that could be found. I'm sorry, Your Highness. Mother was right. Either she's fled the kingdom or she doesn't exist. Thank you. You may go. I think you do under all that grime. Do you work in the palace?
No, Your Highness.
I'm sure I've seen you before, or someone who resembles you. Do you by any chance have a sister?
Two, Your Highness.
These sisters, were they at the ball?
Yes, Your Highness.
Do they look like you?
Well, they're stepsisters, Your Highness.
Stepsisters? Oh.
Is there something wrong, Your Highness?
Just to end up a dream about a glass slipper that didn't fit anyone.
Your Highness, you mustn't give up hope.
It was just a waste of time, a wild goose chase. It was impossible.
But Your Highness, impossible things are happening every day.
Even foolish dreams come true.
Oh yes, if you wish hard enough and believe in what you're wishing, even foolish dreams come true.
Why do I feel, or am I just imagining? Who are you?
Oh, I'm just a girl from the village. I'd better go. My stepmother will be wondering where I am.
Your stepmother wouldn't mind if you were a little late. Wouldn't mind if you were a little late.
Really, Your Highness, I should go.
Yes, I suppose you must.
Well, goodbye, Your Highness.
Goodbye. Oh, wait. At least tell me your name.
Oh, it's a silly name. You wouldn't like it.
Silly name? Like it. Stop! Did anyone try this slipper on you?
No, Your Highness.
I found you, and I still don't know your name.
What's that name? Cinderella.
The most beautiful name in the whole world.
Thank you.
Thank you.